but I'm Canadian. Good?
I hit record for you, yep.
Thank you. Attention all shield, sorry, hold on, introduction. Hi, my name is Luke Thompson, and for my drama presentation, I'm going to do a monologue from Captain America the Winter Soldier, and the little background is, it's whenever he's on, like, telling of what's happening, so giving the knowledge to the people. All right. Attention all SHIELD agents, this is Steve Rogers. You've heard a lot about me over the past few days. Some of you were even ordered to hunt me down, but I think it's time you know the truth. SHIELD is not what we thought it was. It has been taken over by HYDRA. Alexander Pierce is their leader. The strike team and insight crews are HYDRA as well. We don't know how many more there are, but they're probably in the building. They could be standing right, they could be sitting right next to you. HYDRA almost has what they want, absolute control. They shot Nick Fury, and they won't stop there. If you launch those helicarriers today, HYDRA will be able to kill anyone who comes in their way. They have to be stopped. I know I'm asking a lot, but the price of freedom has always been high. I know I'm asking a lot, but the price of freedom is high. It always has been. But that is a price that I'm willing to pay. If I'm the only one, then so be it. But I'm willing to bet I'm not. That is the end.
So I'm going to be playing the character Jody from the movie Tall Girl on Netflix. And what's happening is they're at like prom or homecoming, and she walks in and she goes on stage and she has a speech addressing everyone who's made fun of her in the past long time. Yeah. So. Can I have everyone's attention, please? Hi, my name is Jody. Some of you may know me as Amazon, or Godzilla, or Jody the Green Giant, or any of those other insults you've called me in the past few years. You know what, I get it. I'm tall, like really, really tall. And it's a thing that's haunted me my entire life. So, it's defined me. But I think that it's time I come up with a new definition. I'm so much more than just a tall girl. I'm a sister. I'm a best friend, mostly a good one, sometimes a bad one, I'm sorry. I'm fun, I'm smart, and I've made mistakes. I've kissed a guy who I knew had a girlfriend. I'm sorry, that was wrong. And I play piano, and I'm really, really good at it. And you know what? Being tall is what makes me, me, and I like me. And you should like you, because we're all good enough. And once we realize that, no one can take it away from us. So go ahead, keep making fun of me, keep calling me names, keep asking me, how's the weather up there? Because I can take it. Weather up here, it's pretty great.
I'm So hi, I'm Joshua Perry, and I'm going to be playing David Taylor from, and he's a the CEO of Tide, and he's doing an interview about his products. Hi, my name's David Taylor, and I'm the CEO of the company that makes Tide, and that's what I'm here to talk to you guys about today. You gotta stop eating the Tide pods, okay? Look, I get it. You're young, you're hip. You don't want an old guy like me telling you what you can and can't do. But I'm telling you, Tide is soap, and that's not food, okay? So, please, stop eating the Tide pods. And while you're at it, keep an eye out for our Cascade Dish Pops, the lollipop that cleans your dishes. Wait. Sorry, that lolly. Are we calling it a lollipop? I'd love to see one of these if I could just like fly one in. So our company has been innovating new products since it was founded. And I'm here today to show you Vicks Vapo Rubs, the Winter Blast gum flavored bonbons. I'm sorry, but do these look just like mints? Like dinner mints? I mean, like, am I crazy? What do you mean it's the same as Tide Pods? Now that we're talking about it, what does gum flavored mean in this context? Like, bubblegum flavored? Gum tastes like anything. Crap. We're actually gonna die in court. Are you guys recording this? Can we just like cut the cameras, please? Just cut.
It's about a girl named Tanya who just came back from the store getting her friend's laundry detergent.
Can you explain that?
Oh, no. No. Don't even go there. You have no idea what I have just been through for you. So, I'm at the store looking for your laundry detergent, and then there's a big sign that says, Tide's on sale. I think, perfect. I'll be in and out in a jiffy. Wrong. Well, I get to the shelf, and then the shelf is empty. Except for one small bottle of Tide left. Just as I'm about to grab it, a lady comes barreling down the aisle and snatches it from under my nose. Let me tell you, when I was mad, I mean I was mad. So I stole it from her greedy little hands and say, excuse me, but that's my Tide. Well, she starts chasing me down the aisle as if I kidnapped her son. This was the last straw. I look at her and say, lady, what is your problem? She starts crying and carrying on as if she's going for an Oscar. Just to shut her up, I say, here, take the darn thing. So don't even give me that. You forgot my Tide. Next time, get your own groceries.
Yeah.
it's not working.
So
I am doing a scene from the play Big Nose, and basically my part is me scolding a bunch of light workers. Okay. Where have you all been? Getting ready for what? The apocalypse? I've been waiting here for 20 minutes. We were to meet at the shelter to make our plan of attack. How can you know what equipment you will need if you don't know what disaster we're facing? Oh, I won't want to interfere with a busy schedule. In fact, why don't I tell you when the disaster is coming a week in advance? That way, you can plan ahead of time to make sure that you're free. But that doesn't happen. God doesn't call ahead to let me know when these things happen. They just do, and that's why we've got to be ready. Fine. Why don't you all just go home? Take the day off. When there's an earthquake or blizzard or something, and the people crowd into this shelter looking for help, I would tell them that there's nothing we can do because we are not prepared to help. Go home then. I said go home.
And I'm going to play the scene from a very old cartoon movie called the Iron Giant, and it's about a robot and some bad government guy want to kill him. And I'm going to play the last word the kid's like his owner is going to say to him. Things die. It's part of life. It is bad to kill, but it is not bad to die. Yes, well, maybe, probably, I don't know. You're made of metal, but you have feeling and you think about things. That means you are the soul, and souls don't die. My mom said it is something inside of all good things. And if it goes on forever and ever.
Yeah.
Is that all?
seems that we are eating the, we are the whales eating us.
Okay. Oh wait, is there two chairs there? That'll work.
All right, so I am Marley. This is from
Francesca and Robin, and we'll be doing a scene from The Office where Michael is trying to teach Dwight, who is being played by Fran, how to be not aggressive, hostile, and difficult with their clients. I'll be playing Jim, and Robin will be playing Michael.
Here's what's going to happen. I am going to have to fix you, manage you two on a more personal scale, a more micro form of management. Jim, what's that called?
Microgerment?
Boom, yes. Now, Jim is going to be the client, and Dwight, you are going to have to sell to him without being aggressive, hostile, or difficult. Let's go.
All right, fine. Bring beep. Hello?
Hello, this is Dwight Troop from the Dunder Mifflin Paper Company.
Wow, that's great because I need paper.
Excellent, then you're in luck. We're having a limited time offer only on everything.
Wow, this is my lucky day.
Ask him his name.
What's your name, sir?
I am Bill Butlicker.
Really? That's your name?
How dare you? My family built this country, by the way.
Be respectful, Dwight, please.
Anyways, as I was saying, we're having a limited time offer.
You know what? That's my other line. One minute.
Wait.
Hello?
Yeah.
I'm on the phone with this stupid salesman. He's so dumb. Probably gonna keep him on the line forever and not buy a thing.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll talk to you after.
It's up to you to change his mind.
Sorry, that was a family emergency.
Oh no, what's wrong?
You know what? That's private.
Boundaries, Dwight, come on.
Sorry, as I was saying, we're having a
son, you're going to have to speak louder. I'm hard of hearing.
We're having a limited time offer.
You're still going to have to speak a little bit louder.
Our prices have never been lower.
Louder, son!
Our prices have never been lower.
Louder!
Not liquor! Our prices have never been lower!
Stop it! That's totally inappropriate.
I'm sorry.
You never yell at the client. You never yell at the client.
Yes, Michael.
Words I would describe you as is aggressive, yes. Hostile, and definitely
yes.
Difficult.
Yes. Give me the phone.
Mr. Butlicker.
I'm irate right now.
Mr. Butlicker, please.
He's irate. Give me the phone. Give me the phone.
To give it to my boss.
Give me the phone.
Who is this?
This is Michael Scott, regional manager.
Well, this is William M. Butlicker.
Hello, Mr. Butlicker. How may we help you?
Michael, I like the sound of your voice. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna buy $1 million worth of paper products today.
See us done?
You are the master.
Thank you very much, sir. I don't think you'll regret it.
There is one condition, Michael.
Yes.
You must fire the salesman who treated me so terribly.
Don't do it, Michael.
It's a $1 million sale. Sir, you've got yourself a deal.
I'm doing business with you!